Welcome to beginner's tutorial Microsoft SQL Server part 5.
Today we are going to learn about stored procedure,
how to create it and how to execute stored procedure.
A stored procedure is a set of structured query language statements with an assigned name, which are stored in a relational database management system as a group, so it can be reused and shared by multiple programs. There are so many advantages of using a stored procedure. It manages, control, and validate data. Larger queries can be avoided. It reduces network traffic since they need not be recompiled. Hence, stored procedures increases reusability of code. Permissions can be granted for stored procedures, hence increases security. First, open SQL Server Management Studio. It will take a while. Connect it. In previous tutorial, we have created a database called TestDB. We are going to create a stored procedure in this database. We have already created a table called Customer. In this table, there are some customers' names and their address. Our goal is to find out customer who lives in USA. To create a stored procedure, you have to go to the programmability options. Here you can find the stored procedure. These are system stored procedure. It's used by the database itself. We will create a new stored procedure. This is the template already provided by Microsoft. We can directly edit this template or use this form. Most important thing is procedure name. Give a suitable procedure name. For this example, SP filter customer. Type a parameter name and parameter type. It should be varchar because table data type is varchar. Let's do some manual editing. Give a depletion rate and description of this stored procedure so that we can easily identify the purpose of this stored procedure. We are going to use only one parameter, so clear unnecessary text. Parameter always start with @ sign. You have to type SQL statement here. According to this SQL statement, a stored procedure will output results. It is a beginner's tutorial, so we are going to use Query Designer instead of typing a SQL statement. Type filter parameter here. Finally, press F5 or click execute to finish creation of new stored procedure. Refresh the Object Explorer. Here is the newly created stored procedure. Now, how to execute the stored procedure? It is very simple. Right click on the stored procedures, select execute. Type the parameter value. In our case, it can be USA. But it is showing nothing. Maybe we made some mistakes. Making mistakes while creating a stored procedure is a common thing. Let's check out where we made mistakes and correct those and re-execute. Now we are editing existing stored procedures, so we have to use alter procedure instead of create procedure. Now everything seems okay. It successfully filtered all customers from USA.